We have established that the Google Keyword Planner is the most accurate free keyword research tool on the market with this video right here. If you're interested in checking that out, the link is in the description. But in this video, we will explore the functions of the Google Keyword Planner in depth so that you can get the most out of it without spending a single cent. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that empowers millions of WordPress sites with easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, as well as the right knowledge. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. So there are six ways to use the Google Keyword Planner. Let's start with the first. All right, if you haven't used the Google Keyword Planner for a long time and you've just logged in, you may not recognize this user interface. There should be a button right at the top that will prompt you to check out the new interface. And if you don't see this button, just go to the appearance and click on use new design. Anyway, we'll be using this interface. Now, in case you are in the Google Ads and you don't know where to find the Google Keyword Planner, it is under tools and under planning, you will find a keyword planner here. So let's start with an overall purpose for using the Keyword Planner. Let's say that we are interested in starting a blog that talks about credit cards, and our target audience are people in Canada. That's the precedent. So in the Keyword Planner, you'll be given two options. One is to discover new keywords, and the other is to get the search volume and forecast. We will discuss this in a while, but our focus right now is to find as many keywords as possible related to the credit card niche. So we'll click on discover new keywords, and you'll be given another two options. One is to start with keywords, and the other is to start with a website. We'll talk about this later as well. But for now, let's add a seed keyword. I'm not sure what it is, so I will just add credit card in the field. Now, depending if your blog or business targets a local audience or a global audience, you can change it here by clicking on this. By default, this should be the location you're residing in. If you want to change this to a worldwide audience to see the search volume of a keyword in entirety, if you search for worldwide or global audience or whatever, you will not find the option. So if you want worldwide data, you just have to delete any location here. Save it, and you will see all locations selected. But our target audience are people from Canada, so we will add it in and save it. For now, let's click on get results. And as you can see, we have got 687 suggested keyword ideas. It shows you an average monthly search volume, but it is in a range. It might not be very helpful. But in case you are spending money on ads and the campaign is active, instead of the range, you will see an accurate search volume instead. You could run a $1 a day ad to keep the ad campaign active to enjoy the accurate search volume. But if you don't wish to spend any money at all, I'll share with you a method in a while. But for now, let's say that you want to narrow down the keyword ideas to be more specific to what your blog needs. Let's say that our goal is to create a blog similar to moneysense.ca. Here's the tricky part. Moneysense.ca talks about a wide range of personal finance matters. And when you try to filter the keywords with an URL, it says here to enter a site to filter unrelated keywords. So if we add the MoneySense URL here and hit get results, you will only see 18 keyword ideas, and the remaining keywords are very generic, as you can see. So instead of adding the entire domain, you want to add the URL that contains most of the blog content related to the category you are targeting. It could be a category page URL in your case, but for our case, it will be the credit cards category. And as you can see, this category page contains all the blog posts related to credit cards. So let's copy the category page URL and paste it to the field. Click on get results. And what do we have here? We have got a lot more keywords than before. Now let's check out the keywords. I can see that this keyword includes a year that is not current. Scroll down further. There are a couple more keywords with the previous year. So I can refine the keyword list by checking out the filters on the right. You see in others, it contains the year. If we uncheck it, all the keywords with the previous year will be removed. The same thing goes for any of these filters here. If you do not want to see any keyword suggestions that is related to any of the filters, you can just remove it. Do this for not just one seed keyword. You can add as many seed keywords as you want to expand your keyword ideas. For example, if you want to refine the keyword ideas to keywords that contain best and Canada, you can change or add the seed keyword best Canadian credit cards. And as you get results, you will see all the keywords that contain Canadian, and in some of them they are best compare, and it is getting closer to what I'm looking for. And if you want to know what keywords are related to students, you can change the seed keyword to best credit card students. Hit get results, and here we go. These are all the keywords that relates to credit card and students. So the quality of the keyword ideas depend on the seed keyword you provide. The clearer the intent of the seed keyword, the more relevant the list of suggested keywords. That's one way to use the Google Keyword Planner. The other way is to group the keyword ideas you have found into clusters. Ever heard of keyword clusters? They are basically a group of keywords that have the same meaning or relevance. For example, when someone wants to find the best WordPress SEO plugin, some will search WordPress SEO plugins, others will search WP SEO plugins, best on-page SEO plugin for WordPress, and so on. But is the search intent for all these keywords the same? Yes. So do you write separate articles for each keyword here? No, absolutely not. You want to write one article targeting all these keywords here. And this group of keywords is called keyword cluster. Expanding from our previous example, Google Keyword Planner has already helped us group this long list of keywords. All you have to do is instead of a keyword view here, you change it to group view. But before we do that, you've got to remove the URL here. Otherwise, it won't work. Let me show you. If we change this to group view when there is an existing URL, it won't work. So you have to remove this, get results, and this is the group view. You see, there is a long list of group keywords by their relevance. This is awesome because you get to see all the keywords you can rank for if you were to write one article targeting all these keywords. For example, this, the group is for good credit cards for students. So we can see that the first four keywords belong to the same search intent. But of course, as you are going through the list, you've got to exercise some discretion because not every keyword will fit into one search intent. For example, earlier, these are the keywords targeting students who probably didn't own any credit cards before. But this keyword belongs to a different search intent. And this is more specific because people searching for this keyword wants to find travel credit cards instead of a beginner credit card. But as you go through the list, you'll find many keywords that belong to the same search intent. The good thing about this is that as you go through the list of keywords, you'll find many keywords that answers to the same search intent. So you can assess the average monthly search volume collectively. And that's what I'm going to show you next. Now, as you know, if you run an ad campaign, the average monthly search volume data will be an exact value instead of a range. But if you don't want to spend any money at all, here's how you can get a closely accurate search volume. Let's say we want to know the estimated monthly search volume for this keyword cluster. Let's check this to select all. Let's the keywords that do not belong to the same search intent. The next thing you want to do is to click on Add Keywords to Plan. Once done, when you visit the forecast, you want to make sure that these variables are what you want. Keep the date range as close to the current date as possible because the forecast data are updated with the data from the last 7 to 10 days. I'll explain more about this in a while. What you want to do next is to increase this average daily budget to the maximum so that they will tell you what is the maximum daily budget you can add. For this case, it is $30. Let's add that number in. The reason why we do this is because when you add the maximum budget, your ads will be shown to the maximum number of people, which translates to impressions. Basically, you can consider the impressions as the monthly search volume because if you run ads, your ads will be shown this number of times, which means it has forecasted this number of people will search for the group of keywords. I hope this makes sense to you. But to simplify it, you can consider the impressions as the average monthly search volume. Remember, this data is specific to Canada. And if this number makes sense for you to use your resources to write a piece of content, then by all means. Now, in the past, the Google Keyword Planner will show a list of keywords together with the impressions number right below the forecast. But they have since changed it. That's what I remembered. If I'm wrong about this, do let me know. Anyway, what if you want to know the search volume of a single keyword? It is actually the same thing. You just need to have one keyword in the plan. And to remove these keywords from the plan, simply get to the start of the keyword planner. This is the plan we have just created. Check this. And now you can remove the plan. Anyway, let's say that we want to know the average monthly search volume for the keyword best credit cards for travel. All you need to do is to click on Get Search Volume and Forecast. Add your keyword, click on Get Started. Now, there's only one keyword in the plan. This is the data for Singapore. But take note that this is not the forecast data. We still have to go to the forecast. So if we want a Canadian data, we can select that and this will be changed. Now let's go to the forecast, maximize the daily budget, which is this. And here we go. That single keyword will fetch about 5.6K average monthly search volume in Canada. So just play around with this. I'm pretty sure you will get it. Now let me explain this. It says that the data will be impacted by market changes during this time period as well as the seasonality. What this means is that if your list of keywords added to the forecast are keywords that will be searched most during, for example, Christmas, you may not see any results in the forecast because the current date is not nearing Christmas. This video was recorded in April, by the way. So let's say that we search for this keyword, eco-friendly gifts for Christmas. It will show a range of 10 to 100 for just Canada. Let's change this to worldwide so that we can have a better idea. So it says here 100 to 1000, but this is not the forecast. We want an accurate number. So we will click on forecast, change this to worldwide. And now you will not see any results, no matter how much you increase the daily budget, because not many people are searching for the keyword in April, and the forecast data are updated daily based on the past 7 to 10 days. And that's why you will not see any data. Maybe when it is nearing Christmas, let's say November, then you will start to see some clicks, impressions, and all these here. I hope this is easy for you to understand how the Google Keyword Planner forecast works. Alright, now as we visit the Discover New Keywords option, we are going to explore this option to find new keywords based on a particular website. Let's say that we are interested to know what keywords the moneysense.ca site is ranking for. So we can add the domain URL here, select the country you are targeting, and select Use the entire site option. Let's hit Get Results, and you will see a list of keywords the domain is ranking for. Now, just note that the generated keyword ideas do not necessarily mean the organic keywords this domain is ranking for. These ideas are generated based on the analysis of the internal links, meta descriptions, title tags, headings, and the overall text of the homepage, together with Google's search indexing data. So do not get mistaken that these are all the keywords the domain is ranking for. Pretty sure that there are quite a few, but not every single keyword are accurate. Anyway, don't just stop there. This list of keywords may not far extend to the keywords we are looking for, such as those related to credit cards. You may find some relevant keywords here, but you can also refine the URL input by going to the category page, copy the URL, and paste it here. As we hit Get Results, you will see keywords that are related to credit cards. So if you compare the number of suggested keywords here with the number of suggested keywords when only the domain URL was entered, you will see that the numbers are not matching up. The number of keyword ideas for the domain URL should have been a lot more, right? So this suggests that the domain URL you have entered will not provide an exhaustive list of keywords the domain is ranking for. You have to dig further into the category pages and others to find the keywords that you are looking for. Anyway, if you do research on a couple of competitor sites here, I'm pretty sure you will find many relevant keywords for your site. Often we'll be curious, if you write that article, what keywords can this article rank for, right? I mean, if the article is already written, you can find that information in your Google Search Console and Rank Math Analytics module. If you want to learn more about that, you can check out this video. The link is in the description. But what I'm talking about is knowing what keywords the article will rank for before writing it. The Google Keyword Planner has this function. Let's say that we are interested in creating a page for the keyword best rewards credit cards in Canada. What you can do is to search for that keyword and see which pages are ranking at the top, because they will give you the best list of keywords. Then visit the top ranking page, copy the URL, go to the Keyword Planner, discover new keywords, under the Start with a Website, you want to paste a URL here, and instead of selecting Use the entire site, you select this. Hit Get Results, and this will be an estimate of the keywords your new page can rank for if you create a page targeting the initial keyword. You can even select the group view. You can get even more content ideas through different search intent. to create a group of related content that links with each other. Of course, with this, you can view the search volume of the group to see its traffic potential. Now, if you want to capitalize on the Google Ads to generate revenue for your site, you should take notice of the additional data the Google Keyword Planner provides, particularly the low and high range of the top of page bid, because this tells you how much money advertisers are willing to pay to place ads for each particular keyword. If you check out this list of keywords, you will find some that do not have any data in the columns. That's because advertisers deem that these keywords are not profitable for them. So even if your article ranks at the top for one of these keywords and you allow ads to be displayed on your site, you won't generate much ad revenue from that page. And even if there is some value for the keyword, you need to look at the disparity between the bid range as well as the amount in the low range column. The closer the gap and the higher the low range bid, it means that the advertisers are willing to pay top dollar to get ranked for these keywords consistently. Now, take note that this competition gauge is meant for advertisers and not the competition for organic rankings. High competitiveness means many advertisers are willing to pay top dollar to be featured at the number one spot for the keyword. And as a blogger or a site owner who allows ads to be placed on your site, you will earn much more ad revenue consistently as compared to keywords that have a wide bid range and a small amount for the low range column. Most of the time, those lucrative keywords have a very clear and strong commercial intent. For example, apply for no annual fee credit card has a very clear intent. That person is willing to apply for a credit card that has no annual fee, which also means that person is ready to sign up for a credit card. So with such a clear intent, that's no wonder many advertisers are willing to pay top dollar for the keyword. A better example will be Apply for Credit Card Canada, because it has much more search volume than this. Apply for Credit Card Canada has a clear commercial intent. That person wants to apply for a credit card in Canada. Now, if you compare that to a keyword that has no data, or maybe this that has a very small amount in the low range column, we can see that this keyword is very vague. Rewards Canada can be anything. It can be credit card, it could be a membership. There is no clear intent. If you are a blogger, you won't target this keyword as well, because it is just too vague. And for example, credit card rewards comparison has a small amount in the low range column. That's also because, though in nature this is a commercial keyword, but the intent is more information, because the person searching for this keyword are not ready to commit yet. They are doing research. But anyway, if you want to earn money from ad revenue, this is what you need to look out for. But of course, if your site is new, you've got to do keyword research to identify the search volume and the competitiveness of the organic keyword ranking. If you need help with keyword research, check out this video right here. The link is in the description. With this, I hope you have a clear understanding of how to use the Google Keyword Planner for SEO like a pro. If you have any questions or you'd like to add your knowledge and experience, feel free to leave a comment down below and do help us out by smashing that thumbs up button. If you haven't subscribed to us, be sure to do so to keep yourself updated with the latest on SEO and AI. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.